When I think of home, I think of this house here. I don't think I can say Jamaica is home, but I'm not always in Jamaica. I went back to Jamaica in 2011. I have not been back there since. I moved to London when I was 3. My first house was in Mill Street, but this was the next house that I stayed in. I love my mum. She's cool, you know. My mum, she's definitely crazy. I can tell that. Because the stories my mom telling me, like when she was younger, like back in Jamaica, she used to go into people's gardens and then climb in their mango tree and take mangoes and then take them and then sell them just to make a bit of money to help her family. Like, I'm like, really, mom, you go in other people's mango trees? Everything you see here, it came from her head. I didn't have anything to do with this. The only thing I've done is just help her paint and organize the house and remove everything. But when it comes into bringing ideas, it was all her. And she made these in Jamaica. Yeah, she done all of it by hand. And as soon as I step into this house, I feel like this is a home. Because the way it looks so neat, and we have so much decorations of like bringing extra feeling of the house, you know what I mean? Because my mom said that each time she wants to come home, she wants to feel like she's coming home to her. She wants to come to the house and feel like it's a home. It makes me feel like, okay, I'm in a safe house. I'm in a safe zone. Like, I can express myself. I can chill out. I can do what I want. Like, it makes me feel good and happy that I know that I'm in a house where it's clean, it's presentable, and I can just do what I want. Sometimes, you know, as teenagers, you do upset your parents. But most of the time, she looks at the tank and she just feels calm again. Because apparently, a fish tank can bring up a home even more. It could bring an extra feel of, I don't know, you know, yeah, I feel like I'm Attenborough at the moment, because the way I'm describing these animals, the way I'm describing the fish tank is kind of crazy. But the more I started living here and start knowing my surroundings, I was like, and then I start hearing people getting stabbed and getting shot and getting beaten up because of where they're from, and then we heard like gunshots going off, but at the time we didn't know what it was. We just heard it was like, or a car crash or something, someone must have dropped something that's quite heavy. And as young kids, we went to go investigate what happened. Then we start seeing a crowd, people crowding the chicken shop. A couple of hours later, I heard that a girl got shot in the neck. My mom planned to move out soon. She don't want to live here anymore. Because she said that too many things is going on, like in terms of the area. She just wanted to find somewhere. Sometimes she like, Mark, I want to move outside of London. I'm like, Mom, you're taking it a bit too far. Like, outside of London, do you know how boring it is? My dad is in Bromley and it's so quiet to the point where I can't sleep. I can't sleep because it's so quiet. Because when I live here for so long and I hear police sirens every single night of the years that I've been living here, when I go to Bromley and I don't hear nothing, I'm like, come on, this must be a bit of a noise. Like, come on, I need noise to sleep.
You need the police sirens.
Yeah, I need the police sirens to sleep. And it's a weird request, but the thing is, when you're so used to it, and then when you don't hear anything because it's so peaceful, I'm like, no, I can't live here. Well, my friends, okay. Now, that's where I met them. I met them in the cage or the what's this place called, Shoreditch Adventure Playground, that's where everyone came and I met it. That's when I start to get used to the area because of that playground especially. And then that's where I used to play football. You know that big wall right there in the car park?
Yeah.
Yeah, my friends would just kick the ball against that. And then who has the best touch wins, or... But as I was saying, that if I told my mom that if I do make it well in football, my dad's house, and if you want to stay in it, you stay in it. But like, I'm definitely staying in it.
It's up to you. If you want to stay in this house, I might buy you another house to so you can live somewhere else, but I'm definitely staying in that house. I'm still going to be the same Mark Wright who lives in Hoxton. If I become a superstar in football, I'm still going to live in that house. I wouldn't move. I would buy that house and then try and improve the area. Yeah, yeah.
One love. They're supporting each other.
There we go.
Okay.
Finally. But my mum wants to recognise these looks out of them. she probably will.
Yeah, yeah, she'll definitely recognise it. She'll support it. There ain't no hiding place from the Father of Creation's.